What is going on, everybody? Michael here from The Market Vibe. Welcome back to the channel. So, you guys, I wanted to make this video about Naraka Bladepoint because I know this game came out yesterday. I couldn't really find a YouTube tutorial, so I actually had to go to Twitch and watch my friend Cindy play this game for about 3 or 4 hours before actually deciding if I wanted to get this game, which I ended up getting. And what you're watching is the very first kind of team squad battle or whatever you want to call it that I did in this game. And so I just kind of wanted to give you guys my initial review. I played it about 6 or 7 hours since this first one that you're seeing right now. So altogether I've watched for about 4 or 5 hours and played for about 6 or 7. So I just wanted to give you kind of my initial thoughts, 3 positives, 3 negatives, because I know a lot of people are trying to decide whether they actually want to get this game, because unlike it being free like most other games like it, this game actually costs $20 for the base game, and it can cost up to about $80 if you get the deluxe edition. So I just wanted to give this review because I know that people's money is very valuable, and so just to be able to show you gameplay and then give you kind of some positives and negatives so that way you can make the decision for yourself. So obviously I'll go into the negatives first. So negative, pay to play. So again, obviously this game costs $20. I don't think that that's the biggest gripe that people have. I think the biggest gripe and why so many of the reviews are negative on Steam is because of all of the microtransactions that they hit you with right when you buy the game. So you buy the game, you download it, and then they want you to try and get the battle pass, which costs money, and then they try and get you to get these armor things, which costs money. And so if you're hit with 5 or 6 of them right off the bat after you've already paid money to get the game, and so I think that that's really turning people off as far as pay to play. Number two, it seems like there's some weapons that aren't really useful in this game. Now, again, I was watching my friend play. She ended up using the spear. It looked like it did really well. I grabbed the spear the first round. We end up winning this round, and the spear is really, really powerful. The musket is cool if you can hit people. It's really hard. Again, you see that guy right there trying to hit me with a bow and arrow, and he didn't even hit me. It just seems like there's some weapons that are really hard to use, and you've got to be really good to use them. I would definitely say melee weapons seem to be better than ranged weapons. That would just be my initial reaction, having played that first 6 or 7 hours. It just seems really easy to use melee weapons, especially a spear, just because of the distance that you can keep between your enemy. And then the last thing is what people are calling stun locked, which is basically you get hit once and knocked in the air, and then you can't get up. And so what the developer said is there's no real way to block in this game, but what you're actually supposed to do is you're just supposed to dodge. And so you have stamina and you can dodge. And so it's just simply figuring out how to dodge. And again, I'm going to go into one of the positives, which is movement and gameplay. But it is really, really difficult. So number one positive, again, is movement and gameplay. So the movement feels really realistic, more realistic than I've ever felt in the game before. But it's also very, very difficult because it's so different than anything that I've felt before. So it's just, it's so different, like the jumps and the climbing. It feels very like Assassin's Creed meets, like, I can't even think of what to equate it to, but the movement and gameplay is the number one positive for me. It just feels so fluid and so smooth, especially for a game that just came out, which is crazy to think about. The second positive for me is the armor, weapons, and accessories. And I know I just said that there's, you know, a negative was there seemed like there were some weapons that were useless. But I just like the fact that there's such an array of different weapons, like a musket. You can use a crossbow. You can use a regular bow, a longsword, a greatsword, like a samurai sword. Like, there's just so many different types of weapons you can use in this game. So it really adds that replayability, just having that much difference in the weapons, armor, and accessories that you can use in the game. And then the last thing is just the ability to be able to climb buildings. You can side scale buildings, which is really, really cool. Everything is scalable, which I love in a game, because that does feel like Assassin's Creed. It allows you to be able to get out of situations really quick. So if I was right here and I needed to get out of a situation, I could quickly climb that wall and just go on to the other side. So it makes for some unique battle situations in this game that I could see happening, which could be really, really cool. So those are my negatives. Pay to play. Seems like there's a couple of useless weapons and stun locking. Positives are the movement and gameplay, the fact that there's just such a variety of weapons, armors, and accessories, and then the fact that everything's scalable and you can basically climb everything. So those would be my three negatives and my three positives as far as this game goes. I hope this video is helpful. Again, drop comments below if you guys have questions. This game is $20 for the base game. I personally think that it's worth it. I've definitely gotten my money's worth already. But I'm going to leave the rest of the gameplay going and just drop some music. If you guys have comments or questions, again, drop them in the comments below. Hit subscribe to the channel because we're going to be making plenty of videos like this one. But until next time, guys, this is Michael. See you later.
Turn up the headphones a little bit. Hey. Hey. ISO. ISO. Whoa, let's get it.
Whoa. Clear out the room. I'm coming through. They want to see what I'm about. Yeah, I got skills, do it for the thrill. I'm on a paper route. Extra, extra, read about it. I'm today's trying to tap it. I put commas over bullshit. Yeah, I put that on mamas. They trying to block all my blessings. They thought I lost a snapping. I bet on me and my team. ISO is what I'm rapping. Put on for the whole city. Yeah, I got them rocking with me. I bet on me and my team. ISO is what I'm rapping.
Sending emojis. I'm blowing a pack of that OG. Don't be acting like you know me. And if you did, that's the owe me. Wintertime, rock a cold fleece. Pocket fat, that's obese. Only talking money if it's increased. She give me brain, girl, no teeth. I touch down, bust down. She busted open for a real day. Stay tommied up, tryna build it up, tryna count it up, hill figures. Don't be chillin' with no lil. And if I do, I be real with them. Chase a dream, that's a meal ticket. ISO gang, yeah, they still with us. I put it in motion, they got me steady. Thoughts on my mind, it's weighing heavy. Watch how I shine, tell them I'm ready. I'm hitting my stride, let's get to the Fetty. I was just sitting back watching them fold. Racks on me now, yeah, it's looking slow. I hold it down and I got my own. Keeping it grown, we back to the bone. Yeah, flying flashy, ayy, ayy. We too fancy, ayy. Can't walk past me, ayy, ayy, right up your alley, wait. I gotta play it safe. Watch me isolate, watch me isolate, ayy, watch me isolate. Clear out the room, I'm coming through.